Hello, I'm Michael Stohr, Head of R&D here at ResResult. And today I would like to give you a little behind the scenes view of what we do at ResResult. So maybe most of you are aware that we have our custom ResResult UHF transponder. And the beginning of the season, we started to see something new happening. Actually, we had some customers, just a few, who had issues with transponders failing during the event. And obviously this is very critical. The transponders have been tested in multiple ways along the production. And they were tested right before they left our building. So we knew that they were working. We could look into their data and we saw that they were working. But then during the event, something happened to them that broke them. And we wanted to know what is going on. We needed to figure out what's going on. So just in case you don't watch it to the end, I just want to show you what you should never do with our transponders. Is once you have it attached to your bib, don't rip it off the bib anymore. Don't do this, okay? Don't reattach it. This is the conclusion of this video. If you follow the video, you will know why, but do not do this after you have attached it. If you need to rip the transponder off, throw it away and get a new one. Do not reapply the transponder. Okay, so now we got that figured out. Question is, what happened? So we got reports from the field. It started with a very, very, very early event in the season where somebody had a single transponder, which obviously somehow didn't work in the field anymore. And we looked at that, and it was really strange. We had not seen that before. And we were worried and looking at different options of what could have happened. At that point, that event was a long distance endurance race cycling event with, you know, a lot of bending going on. And our first idea was that somehow the attachment between the chip and the antenna was broken. So if we look at what the structure between the antenna and the chip looks like, you see that small little black dot here is actually this here. And you might see it here. There is a rectangular chip in there. It's a small microchip, which is the actual transponder, which contains the data, which our decoder has to communicate with. This is the backside of that chip, where you can see electrical contact fields called bumps. And those connect to the aluminum antenna via a conductive adhesive. And in the process of manufacturing, this chip is what we call bonding, is bonded to the aluminum antenna by pressure and heat on that adhesive, which cures the adhesive, generates a electrical connection to the antenna and holds the chip in place. Obviously, this is not our process, but as this is our chip and we have very close connections to the people doing this for us, we have very good insights of what's going on there. So if we look again at in a closer view, this is the same setup under an electron microscope. So here you see the rectangular chip, you see the adhesive material, and you see the aluminum antenna on both sides. So on this side, you see the same thing, but with the chip missing, and the stuff you see around here is actually the adhesive on the back of the transponder, holding the transponder on the bib. So looking at this, it was pretty obvious when we analyzed the broken transponders when we got them back from the field that the connection between the chip and the aluminum antenna wasn't perfect anymore. And the question was why? How can this happen? And as I said, the first events that kind of reported this happening were all long distance endurance, multi-day events. So the first idea, obviously, that we had is that somehow bending the transponder or maybe going up and down in temperature might be the issue. So what was done was that we actually put the transponder on a little, you could call it treadmill. So it's basically a machine which has multiple roles in it. And what it does is it pulls through something like a belt, maybe like this. Oh, need another starting point here. And what we do is we stick a transponder on here. Well, not one, but multiple transponders. Let me do that in a different color. And the transponder goes through this machine for hours, bending the transponder back and forth thousands of times. And this way we can simulate the transponder on a bib and trying to reproduce the problem. So after pulling the transponder through this machine for thousands of times, and not only doing it with one transponder, but with multiple transponder out of different production batches, even from production batches we held back from the original production batch where one of the transponders failed, we couldn't see any deterioration. There was simply no evidence that bending the transponder how many times whatsoever would really break the connection between the transponder and the antenna. So the next idea was to put the transponder under thermal stress. So for that, the important factor is to quicken the process. You need to have high and quick temperature changes. So what is done there is that you have a cold temperature oven, or a cooling chamber actually. Oh, let's do that in blue. And you have a hot chamber. And this was thermocycled between minus 20 degrees and plus 70 degrees. And the antenna, a batch of antennas or a batch of transponders, was put from one cooling chamber to the oven and back multiple times, actually 50 times in a row, giving a 70 degrees temperature rise or drop within a few seconds for 50 times. So even after that process, the transponders were still okay. And at that point, we got the feedback from the manufacturers that they had never seen anything like this before. Because typically what happens is if you look at the adhesive between the transponder and the antenna, temperature changes may be the issue because the aluminum has a different temperature coefficient than the glue has. Or bending may be the issue because you have some kind of mechanical problem. But both were not the case. So we could see this by looking at the electrical performance, actually the antenna performance. So these are 50 pieces before the whole procedure. And these are the same 50 pieces after the procedure. What you see here is the RF performance, so basically the sensitivity of the transponder over frequency. And the important fact here is that it looks identical. So there was no electrical difference between a brand new transponder and transponder which was turned and bent lots of times and went through the thermal chamber. It still has the same performance. So there we said, okay, this is not the issue. The question was, what could be the issue? As the manufacturers said they have never seen this before, we looked at different options. So one of the options was that if you look at the adhesive, it is attaching to the aluminum of the antenna. And on one of the transponders, we were able to find some residue of the manufacturing process of the antenna. So if you look at how the antenna is made, actually the antenna is etched. It's an etching process where the aluminum is etched out of a full foil of an aluminum. And in that process, you have certain chemicals, and leftovers of that chemicals could be sticking on the aluminum and could get in between our adhesive and the aluminum, and therefore create a separator which would allow the chip to be taken off the antenna easily. So that was one of the ideas. And if you look closer, this part here is this here, and you see it's some crystalline structure. So it's pretty sure that this is something that shouldn't be on the antenna. So the question was, we found this on one chip. The question was, is this really the problem? So if you then look at one of the chips where the one of the transponders where the chip easily came off, you can do an analysis of the material below the adhesive. So here you see residues of the adhesive, and this is a closer picture and even closer, which held the transponder on the aluminum. And what you can see here is that parts of that adhesive between the transponder and aluminum are still sticking to the aluminum, and parts have been ripped off. On top of that, you see these little dents, little holes, and actually these are coming from the conductive material inside the conductive adhesive. So if you look at how a conductive adhesive is made, it's actually a mixture of a normal adhesive with small particles which are conductive. And they actually create the conductive connection between the gold bottom of the chip and the aluminum. And those dents here are coming from that. So what we could see is that they were denting into the aluminum, so making the electric connection, and that parts of that adhesive were still sticking to the aluminum. So the idea of the of a separator between the aluminum and the transponder was not really holding up. Looking further, we did an analysis on the actual material down here. So this is a spectrogram looking at what kind of material is this actually here between those two adhesive patches. And when we looked at the spectrum, we could see that there is some variation, but it was well in what we were expecting. So this is actually aluminum, and there is nothing on top of that aluminum. And that's the important factor. So looking at all this, we came to the conclusion that the theory of having a separator between the chip and the aluminum antenna was not true. It must have been something else. Now, during all of this, all the different analysis, we found a pattern, a very simple pattern actually out there. Looking at other examples where this had happened, we got a little bit curious of what people were already actually doing with the transponder. So one pattern that emerged was that most of the transponders where this happened were actually delivered on roll. So people ordered a roll of transponders and attached the chips themselves. We never had a case where the chip was actually stuck by one of our machines. So this was strange, because if it is a problem with the chip, it should make a difference if it's done with the machine or not. So what we then got is a sample of one bib where this happened, where we could see residue from the adhesive on our transponder on the other side of the bib with some dirt on it. So it was pretty clear that this chip was placed on the other side by the helper doing the chip attachment. When we then interviewed our customers of what they had done with the chips that failed, it was pretty obvious that this was actually the problem. So what we then found, which might sound like a very simple thing to find after all of this, was that all of the transponders that failed were taken off the bib again. And the issue here is that actually with our glue that we have on the back of our transponder, we found out that after a certain time that of curing, the glue on the back of our transponder is stronger than the glue between the chip and the aluminum foil. Obviously, this is not perfect. So what we did about 2 or 3 million transponders ago is we changed the whole design. So if you get new transponders from us now, the chip is actually on the other side. So the whole antenna, the whole aluminum part, and the chip is under the foam. In that case, you never risk tearing off the transponder anymore. It can't happen. But still, our recommendation is not to take the transponder off the bib once you've stuck it on there, because it still generates a lot of stress to the transponder and the adhesives. So once you put a transponder on a bib and you want to take it off again, throw it away. Do not stick it somewhere else again. So I hope this technical deep dive was interesting and shows you what we are actually doing behind the scenes to make sure that our quality is top notch. We want you to have the highest achievable quality so that you can generate the highest achievable service out there. And obviously detection rates is extremely important, and failing transponders is something that we can't accept. So I hope you liked the video, and see you next time.